you send out my thoughts and my prayers and my heart to any victims' families. Any victims' families or anybody that has been ripped apart by the actions of September 11th. As you guys know, it's been 21 years. So I cannot believe it's been 21 years. It's crazy. I don't have many core memories. Like, I can't, my memory is so bad, like I can't remember times where I knew where I was and what I was doing. But September 11th will go down as one of the days that I will never ever forget. I remember I was in 10th, I was in 4th grade. I was 10 years old. I will never forget my principal. We hadn't even started class yet, and my principal had came into her classroom and said he needed to talk to her teacher, and he brought him out into the hallway for about 10 minutes, and when my teacher came back in the room, he was white as a ghost, and he didn't say a word. He just turned the TV on, first thing that popped up was the attacks in New York City. And I've always felt like a connection to New York City, even though I've never been there. It's always been a dream of mine to visit there. My niece has been there for, she's gone there I think 3 times. And I guess maybe it's rom-coms that I've watched, like Sleepless in Seattle, and, you know, movies that are set in New York City. But that was a very, very hard day, and I know there are families out there that are still grieving for their loved ones, even 21 years later, and children that never get, that never got to know their mom or their father. And that just breaks my heart. And I just want to thank all the firefighters and policemen and even strangers that risked their lives in that day. You are the true heroes. And I just want the families of the victims to know that they are heroes. And I'm praying for you always. But I want to do this video. I'm going to show you guys the gifts I got my niece for her birthday. She is actually coming up over. She's coming over tomorrow. We're going to go to Buffalo Wild Wings first. And then she's going to come over here and she's going to sleep over. And we're going to drink wine and just have a good time. Her birthday is actually September 16th, but she's actually going to see Elton John in Charlotte during that time, so we had to do this just a little bit early. But I've already told her to not watch this video. Actually, I probably shouldn't even show the bag. She'll probably see this, but it's okay. It's okay. Maybe I can... It's okay. I don't care. But I'm going to start with the... This is the satchel bag. She has gotten really into Gossip Girl on HBO Max. And I found this tote bag, or satchel, whatever, on eBay after looking for Gossip Girl merchandise. And I thought she would really like it. But it says, "You know you love me, XOXO Gossip Girl." And it has like a lipstick imprint on there. So that is the satchel that I got her. really spoiled her for her birthday this year. She has been here for me this whole year, you know, spoiling me, and she's the only one that sent me $100 for my anniversary. And things like that do not go unnoticed. And she's done so many great things for me this year, and I just want to give back to her. So I hope she likes everything. I also got her a pair of shoes, because she's always on her feet. She's a CNA like me. And I got her a pair of Skechers from Amazon. And she seems to really like those. The ones she was wearing, the shoes that she was wearing were falling apart. They were like $10 shoes from Walmart. So she seems to be really happy with those, and that makes me happy. So this is the bag that, the Gossip Girl bag that I hope she loves. Let me take a drink right quick. Mountain Dew, my favorite. I don't think there is one drink that Mountain Dew has made that I do not love. Code Red. Is the satchel. It actually has the gift from my mom in there, but since this is a video about the gifts that I got her, I thought I wouldn't show that. Okay, so the next thing is, I actually took the cover off because I only have the one hand, you know. Oh, I'm holding my phone with the other hand, so I can't use both hands. So excited for the day where I can get a microphone and be able to use both hands in my videos. But okay, so this is a Pride and Prejudice lip set. I got this set from Etsy. It's by Flora Lou Studios, and it actually looks like very, very pretty. I'm very happy with it. I thought it would be something cute that she could keep on her little table that we showed you guys in one of our past videos. But like, it looks like the book. It's so cool. And on the back it says, there's a name. The first one is Jane, which is a clear gloss with pink shimmer. The sweetest of shades for the days you wish to feel lovely. The second one is Pemberley. It's a nude rose lipstick. The perfect choice to bring out your natural beauty. After all, what are men to rocks and mountains? And Pride, purple mauve gloss. A subtle statement color to help you hold yourself high and keep your pride from being mortified. And Ardently, muted fuchsia lipstick, a romantic shade bound to make you handsome enough to tempt your crush. And then these are the lip glosses and the lipsticks right here. These are the lip glosses. It's also raining outside. I hope you guys can hear it. Rain sounds relax me out. I don't know about you guys. And then this is the second lip gloss. The after I told the woman, because I just thought it was a little bit too expensive. And I told her, I said, I really want to get this for my niece for her birthday, because she loves Pride and Prejudice. And she actually took $15 off for me, which was so nice of her. So that is the lip gloss set. Scotty.